In this video, we're going to start the CUDA software Infinite Geometry free worksheet classifying triangles. Our directions are to classify each triangle by each angles and sides. Base your decision on the actual lengths of the sides and the measures of the angles. And those are the directions for numbers 1 through 6, which we will complete in this video. However, before we get started, let's go over how to classify a triangle. Triangles are classified by two things. They're classified by angles, and they're also classified by sides. When classifying a triangle by its angle, if a triangle is an acute triangle, that means that all the angles within the triangle will be acute. So all three angles are acute. That means that each of the individual angles will be less than 90 degrees. For an obtuse triangle, one angle must be obtuse. So one angle will be greater than 90 degrees. And for a right triangle, one angle will be a right angle, so one angle will be exactly 90 degrees. For an isosceles triangle, two sides will have equal length. For a scalene triangle, no sides will be equal in length. And for an equilateral, all the sides are of equal length. So we can have different combinations, such as an obtuse scalene triangle, or an acute isosceles triangle. You could also have a right scalene. However, if we have an equilateral, we will just call that equilateral. So let's get started with number one. I'll measure each of the sides in number one in inches. So this first side is approximately 1 1/8 of an inch. This second side is also 1 1/8 of an inch. So I'll write 1 1/8, 1 1/8, and then this last side is approximately 2 1/8 of an inch. So from the sides alone, we know that we are going to have an isosceles, because 1 1/8 of an inch is equal to 1 1/8 of an inch, so those two sides are congruent. And an isosceles triangle has two sides of equal length. However, now we have to decide, is this an obtuse isosceles, is it a right isosceles, or is it an acute isosceles? Let's look at this angle here. When we line our protractor up and extend this line out, we get that the angle measures approximately 140 degrees. So if this angle is approximately 140 degrees, we know that that is greater than 90 degrees. So this is an obtuse angle, and an obtuse triangle has to have one obtuse angle. So since we have one obtuse angle and two sides of equal measure, this is an obtuse isosceles triangle. Let's move on to number two. In number two, let's use centimeters. The smaller side is approximately 2 centimeters. The largest side is approximately 4.5 centimeters, and this other side is approximately 3.1. So you can see that 2 does not equal 3.1, and 3.1 does not equal 4.5. Therefore, no sides have equal length, so we know this is at least a scalene triangle. And if we look at this angle here, we can see when we put our protractor on that vertex, 90 is approximately here, and that is indeed greater than 90 degrees. It is approximately 130 degrees. Therefore, this triangle has an obtuse angle and is therefore obtuse scalene. And number three, continuing with measuring in centimeters, we have 2.2 centimeters. We have approximately 3.2 centimeters. And we have approximately 2.2 centimeters. So you can see that 2.2 equals 2.2. So we have two sides of equal measure, which means that they're congruent. So this we know is an isosceles triangle. However, we have to decide if it's acute obtuse, or right. Looking at this angle here, we can see that if we were to extend this line up, that it will intersect that 90 degree mark on our protractor. Therefore, this angle is a right angle. So for number three, we will have a right isosceles triangle. For number four, switching over to inches, this side is approximately 1 1/4. This side is also approximately 1 1/4. And this side is about 3/4. So we have 1 1/4 of an inch. We have 1 1/4 of an inch. And we have 3/4 of an inch. So these two sides, 1 1/4, have equal measure. Therefore, they're congruent. And since those two sides are of equal length, we know this is an isosceles triangle. Now we just have to figure out whether it's obtuse, acute, or right. Looking at each of the angles, this angle falls between 70 and 80. Therefore, this first angle is acute. This next angle also falls between 70 and 80. Therefore, this angle is also acute. And looking at the last angle, that falls somewhere between 30 and 40. Therefore, this is also acute. So in number four, since all angles are acute and two sides have equal length, this is an acute isosceles triangle. In number five, I'll go back to measuring with centimeters. This first side is approximately 2.6 centimeters. This bottom side is approximately 3.1 centimeters. And this last side is approximately 1.7 centimeters. So you can see that no sides have equal length, therefore this is a scalene triangle. And if we look at this angle, you can see that when you measure it with the protractor, it is a right angle. Lining it up, you can see that when you extend this line out, it will eventually intersect 90 degrees. So since we have one right angle and no sides of equal length, this is a right scalene triangle. And lastly, number six. Number six, I'll measure in inches. This first side is approximately 7/8 of an inch. This next side is also 7/8. And this last side is 7/8 as well. So since all sides are of equal length, this is an equilateral triangle. And with that, we wrap up this video. Join me in the next video where I'll continue on with the CUDA software free worksheet classifying triangles. As always, give me a thumbs up on this video and subscribe to my channel. All likes and subscriptions are greatly appreciated and let me know that you're finding these videos helpful. If you have any questions, feel free to leave it in the comment section below.